Yes, welcome to another series of solving the solution of or finding the solution of quadratic equation using the quadratic formula, otherwise known as the almighty formula. Why is it called an almighty formula? It is called an almighty formula because it solves virtually every conceivable quadratic equation. So, I'm not going to quote the equation for you, but I will show you the step-by-step method of deriving the equation on your own and how you can use it to evaluate questions. So, but if funnily enough, you are looking at the same example we went through using the method of completing the square. So I'm going to use this value or this formula to provide the solution. So the first of all, we have to know what quadratic equation is all about. So quadratic equation is something that looks like this: ax squared plus bx plus c equals to zero, where a, b, and c are constants. They are values, they are number. When you compare it to this equation, you discover that my a here is 1, my b here is 1, and then my c is minus 2. So, but then there must be a criteria. Every other value like b or c could be 0, but what makes it quadratic is that the coefficient of x squared must not be 0, otherwise it is a non-quadratic equation. So if we have this, remember, using the completing the square method, the first thing first is move the constant term to the right hand side. So if this were to be our quadratic equation, we have ax squared plus bx equals to moving the c, which is the constant term, to the right hand side, we have minus c all over a. The next thing, we add half the square of the coefficient of x to both sides. What do I mean? We have, sorry. First thing, we must divide or make the coefficient of x squared to be 1. We can achieve that. I just skipped a step. So divide by a, divide by a. I just skipped a step. So I just skipped a step, and then that is why I quoted this. It's not supposed to be like this, it's supposed to be minus c. So I just assume that I have divided all by the first thing is move this one to the right hand side, I mean the c, which becomes minus c, and then dividing through by a, the coefficient of x squared, such that we have this. So when this cancels this, we have x squared plus b all over a x is equals to minus c all over a. The next thing is to add the coefficient, I mean, add half the square of the coefficient of x to both sides. So we have x squared plus b all over a x plus half of this is going to be b all over 2a, but then the square of it. So we have minus c all over what? A plus half, remember, b all over 2a, the square. So simplify, we can see that the left hand side can easily be factorized. We have b all over 2a, the whole square, then we have x square here. So what do? We factorize. This is going to give us x plus b all over 2a, b all over 2a all squared is equals to minus c all over a. Removing the square, we have b squared minus the square of 2 is going to give us 4. The square of a is going to give us a squared. So that simplifies to minus, remember, 4a square. 4a square divided by a is going to cancel one of the a. We have minus, we have 4a. 4a times minus c will give us minus 4a c. Then we put plus. 4a squared divided by 4a squared is going to give us 1. 1 times b squared is going to give us b squared, which simplifies our right hand side to be b squared minus 4a c all over 4a squared. So taking the square root of both sides, we have at the left hand side, x plus b all over 2a to be equals to, when we take the square root of right hand side, we have b squared minus 4ac all over, remember everything under this 4a square, which we know that we have b squared minus 4ac all inside square root divided by, since we have a perfect square, 2, 4 is a perfect square which gives us 2, and a square is a perfect square which gives us an a. So when we take this one, we move this one, collect like terms, so we have by the left hand side our x to be equals to b all over 2a going to the right hand side becomes minus, so we have minus b all over 2a, then plus or minus, remember to put plus or minus, very important, you're having two values, plus or minus, so plus or minus b squared minus 4ac all over 2a, which simplifies, since we don't know our constant terms a and b, a, b and c, what do? We leave it in terms of a, b and c, so we have this to be equals to minus, remember LCM of 2a and 2a is 2a, so we have 2a, then 2a divided by this will give us, 2a divided by 2a we have 1, 1 times minus b will give us minus b, then plus or minus, remember two values, you are going to have the first value when it is positive, the next one when it is minus, so we have minus b plus or minus b squared minus 4ac, and this is called the quadratic formula. So